Welcome to the African Leadership Series, where we bring you great inspirational speeches of African leaders.
I have lived too long to cherish many illusions about the essential high-mindedness of men when brought into stark confrontation with the issue of control over their security and their property interests. Not even now, when so much is at stake, would many nations willingly entrust their destinies to other hands. Yet, this is the ultimatum presented to us. Secure the conditions whereby men will entrust their security to a larger entity or risk annihilation. Persuade men that their salvation rests with the subordination of national and local interests to the interests of mankind, or endanger man's future. These are the objectives, yesterday unattainable, today essential, which we must labor to achieve. Until this is accomplished, mankind's future remains hazardous and permanent peace, a matter for speculation. I would now like to mention briefly today two particular issues: disarmament and the establishment of true equality among men. Disarmament has become the urgent imperative of our time. I do not say this because I believe that the absence of arms is tantamount to peace, or because I believe that bringing an end to the nuclear arms race automatically guarantees the peace, or because the elimination of nuclear warheads from the arsenals of the world will bring in its wake that change in attitude required for a peaceful settlement of disputes between nations. Disarmament is vital today because of the immense destructive capacity which men now possess. Ever since the Stone Age, the production of arms has always been a source of man's own destruction. Even though the achievement of general and complete disarmament is time-consuming, it is encouraging to note that great efforts are being devoted to attainment. My country supports the nuclear test ban treaty in the atmosphere as a step towards this goal, even though it is only a partial step. The real significance of the treaty is that it admits of a tacit stalemate between the nations which negotiated it, a stalemate which recognizes the blunt, unavoidable fact that none would emerge from the total destruction which would be the lot of all in a nuclear war, a stalemate which affords us and the United Nations a breathing spell in which to act. The goal of the equality of man which we seek is the very antithesis of the exploitation of one people by another, about which the pages of history, and particularly those written about the African and Asian continents, speak at such length. Last May in Addis Ababa, there was convened a meeting of heads of African states and governments. 3 days, the 32 nations represented at that conference demonstrated to the world that when the will and the determination exist, nations and peoples of various backgrounds can and will work together in unity, the achievement of common goals and the assurance of that equality and brotherhood which we desire. Although our position vis-à-vis the power blocks is identified with the policy of non-alignment, our past history testifies to the fact that we have always endeavored to cooperate with all nations without exception. Thus, one of the fundamental principles we have agreed upon at the Addis Ababa Summit Conference gives expression to our fundamental desire to live in harmony and cooperation with all states. On the question of racial discrimination, the Addis Ababa Conference taught to those who will learn this further lesson and until the ignoble and unhappy regimes that hold our brothers in Angola, in Mozambique, and in South Africa in subhuman bondage have been toppled and destroyed, until bigotry and prejudice, malicious and inhuman self-interest have been replaced by understanding and tolerance and goodwill, until all Africans stand up and speak as free human beings, equal in the eyes of all men, as they are in the eyes of heaven. Until that day, the African continent will not know peace. We Africans will fight if necessary, and we know that we shall win, as we are confident in the victory of good over evil. The basis of racial discrimination and colonialism has been economic, and it is with economic weapons that these evils have been and can be overcome.
If you like more African speeches like this, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to catch all our latest videos. Remember to leave your suggestions on the topics you would like us to cover in the comments below.